Hey Lila, so what app are we going to be building in this lesson? The business card camera optical character recognition one seems a little involved for a sample project.
Yeah, you're right. And in this lesson, we're actually going to be building off of an app called DroidTermsExample. Now, unlike the other app, which was storing contact information, DroidTermsExample stores word definitions for use in a glossary. But both of those apps use content providers. Now, instructions for downloading the app are below. Why don't we take a look at it?
DroidTermsExample is pretty straightforward. It's an app for keeping track of all these Android terms you've been learning. Ever wanted to have the definition of adapters and what happens in on-pause on hand?
Yeah, all the time.
Well, Cezanne, in DroidTermsExample, which I have open here, you can view Android glossary terms with their definitions. And then, when you come across a new word, you can add a definition for it, save it, and it'll appear here on the main screen. DroidTermsExample is storing all of this information, including the words and the definitions, on the phone itself using a content provider. Now, what's actually going on under the hood is that there's a SQLite database, and the content provider is just providing managed access to that database. But from a developer's point of view, who's using the DroidTermsExample's content provider, you don't actually need to know that this SQLite database even exists, because you don't have the permission to, and you never will, be accessing the SQLite database directly. Okay, so we've looked at DroidTermsExample. Now, imagine that you want to make an app that quizzes users on the definition of the Android words in DroidTermsExample. DroidTermsExample has all of this word and definition data already, but how can you actually access it? Well, since whoever made DroidTermsExample used a content provider, you can easily access all of this data in your own app. So DroidTermsExample has already been made, and what you're actually going to be doing is making an app called QuizExample. It shows the first word that is stored in DroidTermsExample's data, but with no definition. You can then click Show Definition to reveal what the definition is, and then Next Word to go on to the next word. By creating QuizExample, you'll learn how to access data using a content provider, and this will work for any content provider that's publicly accessible. You'll also learn how to take the data from a content provider and display it in a UI. Follow along with the next tutorial to get started.